This is the JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe.
All right, if you're struggling with Christmas shopping, man, have I got ideas for you.
Hello, I'm Morgan Freeman, here with a holiday tip. Shopping for gifts can be frustrating, especially when the person you're looking for can be a real jackass. This year, get them something more fitting, like a pile of cat a used prophylactic, or my favorite, a firm, well-placed kick in the crotch piece. Not only will you be giving them what they deserve, but my gut tells me you'll never have to shop for them again. Happy holidays.
Aww.
Yeah.
Very practical gift idea.
Always so practical.
Oh, not this asshole.
I know, right? Did we just hit it at the same time?
Oh, dude.
Dick.
Man, what happened to him in that song? Oh, that was... Oh, sorry.
Yep.
That was the... Way too soon.
It will never not be too soon.
Sorry.
All right. So this is a very strange story because it's like straight out of 1999. Consequence of sound reports that Eric Clapton has successfully sued a woman in Germany for trying to sell a single bootlegged recording of one of his concerts from the 80s. She was selling it on eBay for $11. It wasn't even on vinyl. It was a friggin' CD. The woman says she didn't even know she was infringing copyright. Her husband bought the CD at a department store in 1987, and he's dead now, Jim. The judge ruled that it didn't matter that she didn't purchase the CD or that she didn't know the recording was done illegally. The woman is required to pay the legal fees for both parties.
Oh, my God.
Which is about $3,500.
Just call it a wash.
A dude, right? She can't sell the CD. If she tries to, she's going to face 6 months in prison or face a fine of $283,000.
What?
Yeah.
So you say her husband bought it at a record store?
Yeah.
Not even knowing what he was buying, probably.
Right. Probably.
Just anything with the word Eric Clapton on it. He's a fan.
Right. So, yeah.
So she tried to resell it.
Yeah, just selling it on eBay, which I didn't even know. People were buying CDs off eBay still.
Wow.
That's crazy. But it was only going to be $11. And nope, turns out you're going to have to keep that CD.
Bam.
Whatever. I'd start it on fire if I were her. Screw you, Eric Clapton, you douche.
You've got to, it's kind of like you start hearing these stories. You've got to separate your appreciation of their skill.
Yeah.
With the with that side of, like the Tom Cruise, with your dislike of their general disposition.
It's like the more talented they are, the douchier they are.
Well, so I guess his thinking is, I'm sure he's got recordings of it. And if he wants to put it out at a later date, it's weird you cherry pick one show from on a disc if that's the case, if it's one show. And how did it end up in a record store?
Right.
And it was on what format?
CD.
Oh, CD. Oh, I missed the cassettes. Go on for days.
Why? Why do you miss cassettes?
I miss the sound of them, just the plastic, you know, just the loose parts, you know, just the general crappiness of the whole idea.
The whole zen of putting in a cassette. Okay.
You got to remember, I came up driving when the cassette player was the go-to technology.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Like, oh, my God, it comes with a cassette, I'll take it.
And we had, when I was learning to drive, then we had the CD player that you put the cassette in and then it linked to your CD player.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Mm-hmm. It's like astronaut stuff.
Dude, serious space age technology.
You know, the cassette player in cars was pretty short-lived, if I remember right. It had like a good, they were kind of late getting to it, but then, well, the CD just automatically crushed it.
Yeah.
The CD was what, early 80s? I think the cassette player was less than 10 years as a.
So, 1984 was the first CD.
Yeah, Billy Joel.
Car CD player.
Oh, okay.
And then let's see what years.
I bet cassette was like 70, mid 70s to mid 80s and gone.
The first cassette player designed for use in car dashboards was introduced in 1968. From the early 70s to mid 2000s, the cassette was one of the two most common formats for recorded music. But when did cars stop?
Yeah, when
by the late 90s.
When did like General Motors adapt that?
By the end of the late 2000s, very few cars were offered with cassette decks. Yeah. That decks. Jesus Christ.
But I guarantee you, GM was not putting in cassette decks in 68. That was 8-tracks.
The last vehicle model in the United States that included a factory-installed cassette player.
The model? Cordoba.
2010 Lexus SC430.
Oh, wow. 2010?
Isn't that crazy?
That's incredible.
Yeah, I thought that.
Who would want to buy that crappy car? What goes in the hole? Lasagna? What is this?
Lasagna?
Is this a spaghetti maker? What is this? Does toast come out? What happens?
That's like I saw a meme the other day, and it was somebody holding out one of the floppy disks, you know, the hard, small floppy disks.
Right.
And it said, my student goes, oh, you 3D printed the save icon. And I'm like,
yeah.
People, relax.
What a complete waste.
We are killing it online. Have you guys checked the comments?
Of cyberspace.
Smoke That Skin Wagon says, you guys are killing it.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast.
We're internet sensations.
Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
Boozapalooza, now officially underway with the appearance of Nate.
Welcome, Nate.
Nate, the Boozapalooza.
Grab a microphone.
You're the early Boozapalooza,
yeah,
buddy.
Yeah,
style
let's get
points.
It started.
Style
Christmas.
Points. But what do you got back there for the booze?
White Russians.
Oh, yeah, that's right. You are all about White Russians.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
mm-hmm.
My God. That cost me two marriages.
We got vodka and orange juice, too.
I got to do that because I'm sick.
Other options.
So.
Plenty of vitamin C and a splash of Smirnoff.
I love it.
You'll forget you're sick.
Yeah.
You just numb everything.
Yeah, sure. Why not?
All right.
Until I wake up, and then I'm like, why did I do that?
Hey, Nate!
All right, a 23-year-old guy near Seattle drove his Dodge Challenger to a car dealership early Tuesday morning and tried to steal better tires off of one of the cars in the lot.
I just swap out here. I'll be just a minute.
He found another Dodge Challenger they were selling, put it up on blocks, removed all four wheels. Then he drove across the street, put his own car on jacks, and tried to swap the tires out. This seems like a very long process.
Yeah.
But while he was doing it, someone called the cops because they were like, this is really sus. He had the new tires on by the time the cops got there. So when he saw them pull up, he dove into his car and tried to make a quick getaway. But he didn't go anywhere because the back of his car was still up on jacks.
Jesus.
A minor detail that he apparently overlooked. They arrested him without incident and found a loaded gun in his car. Turns out he had 7 warrants out for his arrest, all felonies. Jesus. The new charges were still pending. Dude.
Yeah, you know why tires are so expensive? Inflation. No, forget it. No, it's not even good. Are you saying he tried to drive away? Did he try to drive it away with the car up on a jack?
It was, yep, here. So the tires were on it, but he still had it up on jacks.
Bam, bam, bam.
So it was...
Oh, wow, that car looks like a hot mess anyways.
Yeah.
Yeah. He's not taking care of his car.
That's my dream car. I love them Challengers.
Yeah, get a Hellcat. I heard the insurance is just hell.
I do not need a Hellcat. That's
you do. If you're going to go big, go big.
No,
dude.
That's not.
You don't need 770 horse between your legs?
I certainly don't.
You haven't lived. You haven't lived.
Yeah, and I haven't died either, and I'd like to keep it that way for a while.
That's weird because the top speed on my Toyota RAV is 77.6 miles an hour.
Yeah, and then a bunch of screws start falling off. Yeah, I know, dude.
171,000 miles on it. I mean, I do a lot. I do write in a certain percentage of loose parts driving down the road.
Sure.
It's been holding pretty tight, though.
Yeah.
I got to say, pretty good quality, dude.
Absolutely. I know. But, yeah. I mean, my Honda's near 300,000.
I think I'm going Americana next time.
Oh, yeah?
Looking at those Cadillac SUVs. Huh?
Wait till you almost lose a hood.
Oh, what's your hood held down with? Flex Seal?
Two deck screws and a ratchet strap.
Two deck screws. Seems to be working.
Yep, that's right.
Yeah, you don't want a draft coming into your dash. No hood.
No.
It's the opposite. That's the opposite of aerodynamics. Take that to a wind tunnel. It'll just kill itself.
I'll show you a hood.
Is that a female body part? Is that a vagina part? Is it? I feel like that's part of the vagina.
Uh-huh.
Where's it at?
Part of town.
I'll show you.
You got a dollar bill?
We thought uploading to the cloud was something completely different.
Come on, Watery.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast. Johnny and D, JJO.
Hi.
Hey.
Okay, Florida.
Florida? But that's America's wing.
Florida man says he was kicked off a United Airlines flight Wednesday for wearing women's underwear as a COVID-19 face mask. Adam Genet of Cape Coral said he wanted to make a point about what he regarded as the silliness of people having to wear masks on planes.
Does it count if it's a crotchless pair of underwear with the?
It doesn't count if it's a regular pair of underwear.
With the hole right there?
He said he's been wearing women's underwear to highlight the absurdity of masks since last summer. Cell phone footage recorded by Jenna's girlfriend shows a flight attendant telling him he's not in compliance with the airline mask rules and must leave the flight. It says here several other passengers left the flight in solidarity with Jenna, which I cannot believe. What is that quote? Who's more foolish, the fool or the fool who follows him?
Ooh.
Right? Obi-Wan Kenobi, you son of a bitch. He later received an email from United telling him he was banned from all future flights till his case had been reviewed by a passenger incident review committee.
Now,
is that the first time he's been kicked off a flight for pulling the stunt? Last month, Delta kicked him off a flight for wearing women's underwear as a COVID mask, too. Janae insists that most airport staff and flight attendants, while tired of encounters with unruly passengers, actually get a kick out of his gimmick. I'm willing to bet they don't. The flight attendants are tired. Yes, they are. So stop making him work harder.
Here comes the panty sniffer.
They're worn out of this stuff. But everybody that I encounter, almost 100%, finds the entire thing hysterical. I can guarantee you the flight attendant does not want to take time out of its pre-flight ritual to kick you off a flight, no matter how hilarious the underwear are on your face. Just let them do their job.
I would pose for pictures with that guy. Now, if you're wearing panties on your head, now follow me here. Now, if you're wearing cotton, what kind of panties do you wear?
Cotton. Well, yeah, cotton. That's got to breathe.
Bada boom.
Jesus Christ.
Now, that's as good as a stupid gator. That's okay. Unless it's the stripper, see-through mesh panty. Gauze.
They're hanging loosely off his face.
Right. But I'm saying if they're cotton, that's no different than that blue mask. A gator. I'll go with a gator.
Sure. Whatever. It's
a gator.
I'm not going to argue this.
Well, what are we talking about?
It's because, in my opinion, you're flying on a plane. You need to follow the rules. And clearly, that is not a mask. And clearly, you are just effing with people who are trying to get through their day.
Right.
You need to follow the rules that the airline sets out for you because that is not an inherent right you have to fly. It is a privilege.
No, they're a private company. They can do whatever they want.
Right.
I get it.
So, I mean, I would, if I saw that in a store, I'd think it was funny. But when you're on planes, you're in that's a whole different category of effing around, dude. Can't eff around on a plane. And if you want to go ahead and get yourself banned from every damn airline, you go right ahead.
Is it worth it? No.
Right.
Does he make an interesting case?
Sure.
Yes. Depending on the material.
Yeah.
Unless you're offended or somebody is offended by the sight of women's panties.
Right, exactly.
Which,
but totally. I would.
Especially if they've got like a Santa motif.
Oh, ho, ho, ho.
Ironed on. I won't go there.
I mean, it's stupid, and we all have COVID fatigue. I get it.
These masks on airplanes are feeling a little ridiculous. You sit down, you eat, you take your mask off. You eat a peanut, you take your mask off. What are we talking about? Either put them in a deep sea diving suit or don't wear a mask.
No.
What makes a difference if you breathe a little COVID around the airplane?
Because that is a difference.
No, it's not.
Yeah, it is. It has to do with the amount of time around the viral load. Yeah.
Wee. Man.
But I don't really care. I ain't here to argue the logistics of masks. I am here to tell you that that's the rule on the airline.
Is it worth not getting to your tropical beach destination?
That's what I go over every time.
Hell no.
Is it worth being on a no-fly list?
No.
No. Just, I understand the point you're trying to make. We're all tired of masks.
Yeah.
Very much so. But that flight attendant just wants to get through its damn shift.
Look, he could have made his point by wearing, what's the blue medical, the basic called, whatever. I don't know if, that's not an N95. What's that just called?
No, it's just a cloth mask.
Cloth mask. If he would have wore the panties over the cloth mask.
Sure.
I think we would have been
then
in
you
business.
Won't get kicked off because you're still in compliance.
Right.
But you're still making a point.
Right.
I get it.
What's that, Nate?
I don't think you want to be in eternity with a pair of women's panties on your head either.
Right.
Don't tell me what to do with my women's panties.
Your women's panties.
Oh, yeah. I have my own.
Your own drawer.
Shouldn't have said that out loud.
That's nice. You like lacy ones? What do you like?
Good morning.
Oh, it's crazy. Speaking of flying, me and my wife just got back from Cancun. Johnny, you'd love it. They actually make you wear a mask in the resorts down there. You sit at the Hard Rock.
Oh, yeah. We're going in about, I don't know. About 4 weeks.
Like when you're
there.
Sitting in the pool at the swim-up bar?
No, outside it's okay, but anytime you're inside, you have to have a mask.
Gotcha.
See, this is where we were in.
They don't even have OSHA. There's like no child labor laws. Like seriously, like they're all wearing masks and they're outside. And I feel bad for the employees that make no money and
right.
just live off tips. They are out there all day long with a mask on, and they're out there by the pool. It was like 85 degrees every day, super hot, beautiful, loved it. And it was just ridiculous. They make the employees wear that.
That sucks, dude.
Now, when we were in Vegas last year, we were at the Mirage, and they were really strict. We got into the pool. Okay, so if you're anywhere you're going, we had to have a mask on, right? This is last September. You had to have a mask on. Now, outside at the pool, right? Okay, you had to have a mask when you sat at your chair, your deck chair, right? When you got into the pool to drink your booze, you were allowed to take your mask off.
Right.
They wanted you six feet away. Now, when you got into the pool, we were partying with people from Detroit, L.A.,
yep.
San Antonio.
The pool doesn't have COVID, dude.
I drive me crazy.
It drives everybody crazy.
And then as soon as we got out of the pool, you in the stupid shorts put your mask on. I'm like, are you freaking kidding me?
Yep.
I'm not traveling anymore. It's just irritating. It's like, you know what? I'm on vacation. I don't want to deal with this.
Yeah. Amen, dude.
It's crazy. And I'll tell you what, there's no end in sight either because it's just like it's going to be the next variant.
Mm-hmm.
And it's just going to, I'm a nurse and I just know that I'm going to be wearing the mask the rest of my life at work. So.
Yep.
It's all good.
We're going to have variants until we die. It doesn't matter. You're going to have to just look, you're all going to get it. You are all going to get COVID in one form or another.
Yeah,
it's true.
Move on.
A couple of years.
Driving me crazy.
But that's what's going to be herd immunity. They're saying like within the next like probably year, like we'll get to that herd immunity, which will be like 80% of the Americans have gotten it. They already said that there's over like 130 million Americans that have had it, and you know that's underreported. So a lot of people have had it.
Yeah,
and the best immunity is natural immunity by having it, without a doubt.
Yeah, I wish we would have went down that path a little bit longer and a little bit more scientifically. That was never kind of brought into the equation,
which
pisses me off. Because I didn't want.
Years from now, there's going to be books about this.
Like, oh yeah.
Write
yep.
about how it was just so mismanaged and how it was a money grab and how Pfizer and Moderna just like they're just like. $700 a pop, these vaccines are. Look it up. Google it. It's $700 a pop.
I'm going to tell you something, and this is really weird, and you're going to think I'm crazy. I'm the crazy DJ. Not, and there's a difference between wacky and crazy. Hey, let me, because I love wacky. I think I have, and I didn't get it until I got my shot, whatever, 2 months ago. I think I have COVID toe.
What?
Oh, my God.
No.
You and Aaron.
Dude, listen to me, and it's not, what's that phantom thing? What's it called when you think you have a phantom?
Well, phantom pain is when you're an amputee.
Well, forget that. It's not that.
You got, like, Munchausen.
Okay, on my right foot, and this started after I got my vaccine.
Don't.
You know the toe that's bigger than the big toe that's right next to it?
Yeah.
Toe number two. I cannot press down on it almost. It's painful on the tip.
You got some gout in there, bro. You're an old man.
I've never stubbed my toe.
He's got the
I don't have an ingrown toenail. There's been no trauma to the toe. I think I have COVID toe. And it's getting worse. No, sure. And it's getting worse. And there's no bruising. There's no anything. Nope. Now
it's gonna take a while. It's gonna take months for that to go away.
Oh, how do you know that? Are you guessing? What do you mean? What if I lose a toe?
Well, no, it's because there's no acute injury. It's just all of a sudden started hurting,
mm-hmm.
and it's painful. Well, that's what. Older, right?
That's
you're like, what, 38 or 39 or something.
Hey,
listen to this
Johnny
guy.
Johnny Cakes to me, bro.
Now you're wacky. that's what I hate about it. I didn't do anything to it, and there is. I'm not saying it's severe. I can still.
I think you should report this side effect to the vaccine companies.
I'm going to call Alex Jones and tell him what's happening to my toe and see if he can figure it out.
Oh,
maybe it's the Martians.
I think you need a booster right in that toe.
Yeah, right. Yeah,
ouch! God, that sounds
God,
painful.
God, that does.
No, I think I'd rather live with it. All right, man, thanks.
Like, hit me. Right, later.
Hit me again. Hi, how's it going?
Some bitch, you got Aaron Rodgers toe.
I do.
Dude, you were sitting here talking smack about his COVID toe.
You know what?
And then karma was like, psh.
You're right about that. I've been very reluctant to sound like a pussy talking about my toe. And then finally, I don't care. I'm going to, if I'm the guy that has to show the world, me and my toe.
Uh-huh. Show the world what?
That there's a chip in the vaccine and it's coming out my toe.
Dumbing down your smartphone. One podcast at a time. Listen, rate, and subscribe to the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
An MTA manager claims an inflatable doll that's been riding shotgun in his Kia Telluride is there for the company and not to skirt the HOV restrictions. So he was using the carpool lane because he had a blow-up doll in his passenger ride.
The object is to have multiple people in there.
You need to have multiple people.
Carpool lane.
He did not have multiple people.
Is that his girlfriend?
It's a man blow-up doll.
I saw it. No, it's the blow-up doll from Airplane. Didn't he have the flight suit on?
Yeah. Well, it's...
The blow-up doll.
I don't know if it's from Airplane. I don't know. I've never seen that movie. it's autopilot.
You should learn, you'll learn jive. You ought to watch Airplane.
I don't know if it works that way. Just watch it and then I learn jive.
There's a scene that teaches
I know.
You. Okay. Well, how do you know that, but you've never
seen
the movie?
I've seen that scene.
Oh, okay. All
right. A lot of those movies, I've seen the important scenes,
mm-hmm.
and that's about it.
Right on.
I don't know. Julio, I think his name is. General superintendent at the MTA buses department. So, yeah, that's a problem. Pulled into his Brooklyn office building early Wednesday morning with a blown up dummy plopped in the front seat. He's been confronted. He denied that he had the suit sporting businessman in tow to illegally cruise in lanes reserved for high occupancy vehicles.
Bullshit.
Sorry. He was pressed on whether he used this dummy to use the HOV lane, and he said, "Have I ever lied to you?" So the answer is likely yes, according to his coworkers.
It's a mature response.
Yeah. It's unbecoming of a manager, they said. So they're investigating to see, he might be in trouble for this. Inflatable dolls and other dummies are a common trick for people who want to skirt HOV rules.
Yeah.
There's a doll called Carpool Kenny available online for $14.79.
He comes with a huge wang for you ladies listening in.
Two people were caught with mannequins in their cars in New York in 2019, one in Brooklyn and the other on Long Island. The two men were pulled over by cops who suspected funny business after spotting phony passengers through the windshield. Yeah, that's kind of creepy, too. Both men allegedly attempted to disguise their mannequin in a baseball cap and hoodie.
Oh.
Duder, this Julio fella, has a couple parking violations so far this year. And then he's got another one driving without a front plate. Still didn't have a front plate when they found him on Wednesday with a blow-up doll. So weird.
Blow-up
dolls.
Does
it save that? Does that really save you that much time in New York? Probably, I guess. I don't know.
You could call it your emotional support rubber doll. And take it on airplanes and stuff like that.
It still ain't going to let you use the
right. Well, carpool
lane.
Well, maybe if you get your own designation. You say, look.
No, you can't.
I have to have somebody to talk to. And
it's got
to
be a real person.
I'm not very popular. My doll, I hear voices, but only from rubber dolls. What do you think of people like JFK that sleep with rubber dolls?
Well, who else is he going to sleep with?
I don't think there's like some emotional disconnect between people. I don't think they see a difference between a sex doll and a human. You know what I'm saying?
I don't know how we got on this subject.
Well, the blow-up doll.
But it wasn't even a sex doll.
Well, it's more interesting if it is.
And those sex dolls, the expensive ones.
Yeah. They talk. They're learning like velociraptors, and then they respond.
I'm going to chime in and say anything's a sex doll.
If you push hard enough.
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. What if it's like that iRobot kid? It's a droid.
Oh.
Then what? Are you aligning your okra?
Well, it's...
Yep.
Yep, good. The F and G.
Dude, not the F and G. Don't make fun. You know what? People oft mock what they don't understand. Isn't okra isn't Danica Patrick all about the okra?
Yes.
She talks about her okra all the time.
Yeah. Bam. See, I'm a good listener. I don't even know what okra is, and I'm repeating it. What?
Yeah. It's good pickled, I'll tell you that
great,
much.
It's great in a Bloody Mary.
You can learn a lot listening to podcasts.
Did you know that the hottest chili pepper in the world is so hot it could kill you?
Or you can listen to this one.
Bears can smell your menstruation.
I can smell your menstruation.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast. Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.
I'm on my last break, okay?
Are you insane? Management's going to hear about this.
Think that's a threat? If you think you can make my life any worse, you go right ahead. Be my guest. Take a shot.
All right. So Arby's started selling French fry flavored vodka last month. Remember that?
Oh, yeah. I saw that.
Now the makers of Lay's potato chips getting in on that action with a new vodka of their own. They partnered with a company in Portland, Oregon called Eastside Distilling. Unfortunately, it's already sold out. They announced it yesterday, started selling bottles online for $40 the same day, and they're already gone. I'm not clear on if they plan to make more. I would assume they do, because why would you not make something that sells out that quick?
Right.
They use Lay's proprietary potatoes to make it. So it doesn't really say anything about it actually tasting like Lay's chips. It's just made from the same potatoes that the Lay's chips are made from. So it seems kind of crappy to me. It's just a marketing gimmick. I want it to taste like a friggin' Lay's potato chip.
Right.
Right? If it's going to be Lay's vodka, it needs to taste like the potato chip.
You would assume.
Yeah, totally.
They're using the logo. I just looked at it. They're actually using the same logo with it.
Yeah. So, and then you can't, if you did buy it, you obviously can't resell it because you need a liquor license to resell.
$40 a bottle.
And if you think Eric Clapton coming after a lady for a bootleg CD is bad, wait till you see the booze Nazis coming after you for trying to sell booze without a liquor license. But yeah, I'm disappointed because the premise of it is kind of cool.
It'd be like the Lay's logo or advertising line. You can't drink just one shot. Isn't that what they say? You can't eat one?
I would assume that somebody's going to have a problem with that advertising.
You don't... That kid in the mall with the flask. I'm reminded. Well, Timmy just can't have one.
Oh no.
The like a sour cream and onion vodka. You could go off.
Sure. Well, even like a regular standard Bloody Mary.
Well, now you're Bloody Mary flavored vodka. I mean, now you've got your peppers and your garlics and isn't that great? Fromey's, the place up in Chippewa Falls.
Mm-hmm,
they
mm-hmm.
make the best flavored vodka on earth.
Dude,
I lie not.
I lie not
unless it is with your mother. Did you say, I don't remember the Arby's French fry vodka.
I think you were on vacation.
Yeah, okay. Why don't I wish they'd send us this stuff so we could chat it up.
I know. They don't care. I try to get us free stuff and nobody loves us. It's all right. I've adjusted.
Yeah, I was at the... what country show was I at earlier this summer?
They had the crinkle fry or the curly fry.
The Blake Shelton. Oh, that looks good.
Doesn't it?
Brown baguette in the parking lot of an Arby's.
I mean, you can make your own. Just soak your fries in vodka.
I've got the meats. Yeah.
Someone still has time to bring us some.
They're all sold out.
We're here till 10. I was at the Blake Shelton show earlier this year.
Gay.
Hey, have fun with that.
A little gay. Tito's. Have you ever seen Tito's set up at their promotional at a concert, event?
The Tito's street team people are incredible.
It's like a city when they roll these trucks in and they put the awnings out and the tents. They've got hot chicks. And I'm like, what's it going to take to get old Tito's love?
Yeah. I think it depends on where you're at as far as like what state you're in, because different states have different booze marketing laws.
But also, doesn't Blake Shelton have his own vodka?
He does.
Tito's was
called,
at his.
It's called Smithworks, and it's amazing.
I thought it was pretty good, but he was at.
Grab a bottle of it sometime.
Wait, hold on.
I can. I'm
so
too
Tito's
excited.
Tito's was at his show.
Yeah, Tito's was there too.
So they probably bought a vendor space.
Yeah, something.
He's not really pushing it out there. Now, when we saw him at the Milwaukee show, they weren't really pushing Smithworks. But when we met him, he made us. This was really bizarre, dude. Talk about surreal. We're back there with a meet and greet with Blake Shelton. Yeah. Blake Shelton goes, hang on a minute. You try our vodka? He goes over there and makes us a vodka drink.
And he stirred it with his penis.
Yeah. I reckon he did.
I mean...
That's like, not believe
it. Does he call like it old red?
For being a really tall guy,
it's like some
not
of,
a big penis.
Some kind of mind
it's
control.
It's a bad backdrop, though. He's got huge thighs.
Yeah. A little weird he was in a bathrobe. Yeah, I don't know. It was a little strange. No, I'm kidding. It's super good.
Yeah.
Smithworks. I'm just saying. If you're out there trying new vodka, give it a shot.
I like the vodkas that don't give me terrible hangovers.
I had a hangover, but that's because I drank 47 of them.
Well.
That'll happen.
Well. Sometimes it does.
Boy, he makes them strong, too. And he sat there and drank three mixed vodka drinks and went out and played for 3 hours. It's like they're right. Yeah. They weren't kidding. You are an alcoholic.
Yeah, a functioning alcoholic.
He's a functioning alcoholic.
Yeah, I mean, good for him.
Maybe there's...
There
might be hope for the rest of us.
Right.
Good for him, he says. Jesus.
Oh. What do you got?
The rum chata.
The rum chata.
These shots?
Booza palooza.
Thank you. It's coffee creamer, yeah. So there's no alcohol in it. All right.
There is. Okay.
So I forget, you just do this as a shot, right?
You can.
The rum chata creamer.
Do you have any okra?
You don't. I don't want to taint my white Russian with a rum chata, do I?
I would not taint it.
Yeah.
Are we just going to do this as a shot?
It might be a little heavy,
Christ.
But I'm rashing. A little creamy.
Thank you. Thank you for rashing.
Hey, grab the cheese.
Wouldn't do shots of cheese.
Here's to the WTF Christmas music promotion that nobody seems to grasp.
What do you do with that?
Cheers! 10 years later.
Hey, how's that work?
Replay today the JJO Morning Show podcast. Get up with Johnny and D. JJO.
Butthole, boy. Oh, seriously, I'm a doctor. Sorry.
So there was a pretty crazy UFO sighting that TMZ posted the footage from. It is nuts. It's from Chino Hills, California. A bunch of giant orbs circling each other, moving in weird, strange patterns. No light source coming from down below. There's a bunch of different pictures, too, that people got. Videos from the ground. There's videos from high up. Pretty crazy.
Pretty sure those are turkeys. I've seen that show before.
I don't think so.
Stupid.
Like I said, there's no real beam coming from down below. So after about 30 or 40 minutes, everything disappeared without a trace. Now, let's not forget that there's a whole new system of government. The Pentagon's dedicating an entire wing to studying all these UFO sightings, but that doesn't mean they're going to tell us what's happening. They're not really, government not really good at telling the truth. Just throwing that out there.
I saw some footage, again, military stuff. They're releasing a little bit of this stuff, declassifying a little bit of it. Six flying in a formation of some kind.
Yeah.
Almost like a wing. I don't think you could call it one connected wing, but nobody can figure it out.
Yeah.
I mean, I like it when pilots don't know what the hell they're
when
looking
pilots
at.
Pilots are freaked out.
Yeah, that's when you're like, okay, now we're looking at something good here.
Yeah.
Air Force pilots, commercial pilots.
Sure.
Because they see it all.
Yeah.
You know, I assume they know an enemy aircraft when they see it.
Right.
But a disc moving at the speed of light. Mm-hmm. Oh, my God. Yeah. And it sounds a little something like...
Okra.
You get a tuning fork. You get a Oh, that's okra. Wrong okra.
Where did mine go?
Oh, it's in the utility drawer.
Okay.
The junk drawer.
Yep.
Betty White wants you to join her in celebrating her 100th birthday on January 17th. Well, that's a whole month away, so... Sure, you should be planning for that for one day only.
Would you put that on Betty White?
Dude, for one day only on the 17th, Betty White, 100 years young, a birthday celebration, will be shown in 900 theaters across the country. Movie will include funny moments from her life and career, like The Golden Girls, The Proposal, even Saturday Night Live. A last episode from her first 50s sitcom will also be shown. Betty said, who doesn't love to party? This one's going to be great. Her birthday celebration will include a lot of guests like Ryan Reynolds, Tina Fey, Robert Redford, Clint Eastwood, Morgan Freeman, Carol Burnett. Tickets are on sale at fathomevents.com. I love Betty White so much, and the day she dies is going to be awful.
You're going to be a mess.
I know.
I think she's going to outlive you.
Me? Yeah. Sure feels like it. Sure feels like it.
Put some more Dayquil in your screwdriver there. You'll be fine.
Well, I need to time it out.
With what?
I need another hour before I can have another dose.
You gotta be in sync.
Because if you can't have too much. And I'm not supposed to have more than 3 alcoholic beverages.
Right.
What happens if you do?
The top,
it's a blast.
Yeah, it's a great time.
I believe the sweater comes off.
Speaking of, you're talking about orbs earlier. Never
mind. Yeah. Gorilla.
Betty White, I was trying to think of my understanding of the television industry. She's like, if you go back to the beginning of television, that's her.
Yeah.
Talk about OG, dude. Now you're, and then at the beginning.
Yeah.
You know, like you could say John Wayne. Well, no, Betty's older than John Wayne would have been. Or like a Jimmy Stewart. At the beginning. Of that generation of television, and then the boomer generation of television, like a like a Robert Redford, like you just said, something like that. You know,
she was there before TV.
She was right. Yeah. Sure, she was.
She was literally born before sliced bread.
Is that true?
Man, she's
a
looker.
I'm pretty sure that's a, oof, that's a thing.
Why did it take them so long? How did they eat bread before they sliced it?
I don't know. It was a,
that's what I was. What did they just
look it up? Hey, you're the master of Googling.
You ever see them just break it in half and?
Oh, and then just gnaw on it. Yeah. You just gnaw on it.
The body of Betty White, Kevin Frey.
You would break bread with me.
Right. Circa 1940. She looks pretty good.
Oh, yeah. She was gorgeous. I'll tell you. I watched a little bit of It's a Wonderful Life. Donna Reed, dude, in that era of It's a Wonderful Life, which was what, like late 40s? God, was she beautiful. One of the most beautiful women on earth. Got to go back and look at the old broads. They're beautiful.
Yeah, I know. It was a, well, and then I always wonder, when I look at like those old movies and stuff, like, you know, them women weren't getting treated right. Like, everybody was making comments or whatever.
They were a commodity. Yeah, definitely.
You know? Old.
But you had to be, unless you were a Lucille Ball or a Betty White, then you had leverage.
So I just looked up things that Betty White is older than. Betty White is older than penicillin.
Oh, wow.
She's older than, sliced bread was invented in 1928, it says.
What? So we got to figure out.
She's older than sliced bread.
We got to figure out so it was a loaf, just a loaf.
She's older than sliced bread.
Pass the loaf.
So then you had to slice it?
Right, now you go, pass the loaf, I'll gnaw on it. And then you pass it to the next guy.
Older than scotch tape or canned beer.
Oh, that's funny.
Let's see, traffic signal, that one's kind of boring, but Stacy will like that one. She's older than bubblegum.
That's crazy.
Older than the Slinky.
What a chewing gum.
I'm just going to go through. She's older than birth control. I mean, there's that. Let's see. There's nothing else. She's older than a trampoline. And LSD. She's older than LSD.
About bubble wrap.
Older than jukebox and Barbie. Yeah, so yeah, she's older than a lot of crap.
All the stuff.
Older than a notebook with spiral binding. Yeah, I mean, that's.
She should do
paper.
Is she mobile? Can she?
That's what I was going to ask.
Can she move?
Off. Yeah, I think so.
Yeah,
okay. You ought to do.
Thanks for describing what mobile meant.
We're mansplaining.
Shut up. You just shut up over there. Mansplaining everything all the time. She should do stuff that a 100-year-old person, if they even get to that age, will never be able to do again, like set the 100-meter record. Even no matter if it takes her an hour, she'll have the record.
Right.
Because she's 100.
I hear what you're saying.
Put her on Blue Origin. Shoot her ass into space.
Just shoot Betty White's ass into space.
Her skin starts peeling back because she's like shooting in the G-forces.
What a way to go.
Wow, she looks young again.
What a way to go.
The JJO Morning Show Podcast with Johnny and Dee. Listen, rate, subscribe. Catch a new show every Monday through Friday, 6 till 10 a.m. on 94.1 JJO or streaming anywhere in the JJO app. Johnny and D, nowhere but JJO.